Blog Talk Radio.
Welcome to my show tonight. This is Ruby, and the title of my show is Ghost in My House, because I have been receiving so many messages from people all over the world asking me for help with ghosts in their homes. This has been happening all in the month of May and June. Now, I would love to come in everyone's house personally and help them, hold your hands, and teach you the principles, but this is just not possible. So this is the next to the best thing that I can do. If this has been happening, perhaps you've never heard of it. This show is still for you. Perhaps you have a friend this has been happening to. Or you think, okay, Ruby, you flipped your wig tonight. But let me tell you, there's things happening fast all over the world, and you need to listen, even if you think this will never happen. I have a website. The name of it is rubystabletalk.org. If you've left me a message, I'd like you to know I'm not able at this time to answer you back, but I do see your comments. If you wish to message me, please leave me a message here on Blog Talk or on my YouTube channel, Ruby's Table Talk, and I will answer you right back. Now, first, there's not such a thing as a ghost. You see, they're spirits. When you die, your body rots in the grave and goes dust to dust. That's in Genesis 3:19. Your soul waits for judgment, but your spirit, it either goes to heaven or hell. And hell is a holding place where you wait for judgment. That's in Jude 1:6. And then on judgment day, if you've been waiting in hell, you're cast into the lake of fire. That's Revelation 20. And 10, both are very real places, and you cannot be prayed out of them. So if you really are going to either one of these places, you're there for keeps, and your spirit does not roam around. You go there. It's final. Every man is given once to die. That's Hebrews 9 and 27. You go to a person that's called a medium, and they call up these kind of spirits. You go to them, you pay a fee, and they talk to the dead relative. Now, this spirit is called a familiar spirit. And their type of work is called necromancing. And this is talking to the dead. Now, these spirits know everything about you, you as a person and all your family members. They know your past, and they make you think that they even know your thoughts, but they don't. And this is why they're called familiar spirits, because they're very familiar with you. They'll even lie to you and try to get you to follow after Satan. And they will always try to cause havoc in your life. No, this is not from Yahweh. These are the fallen ones. This is why we are told to not go to this type of people. Do not play with Ouija boards, tarot cards. Do not have your fortunes told. All of these are dealing with familiar spirits. All this attracts these spirits unto you. If you went to a fortune teller and you thought it was just a joke, it was just a big deal, guess what? It wasn't. You've opened yourself up to be tormented by these familiar spirits. These people are dealing with the demonic realm, and you've just played with fire. Play with fire, you generally get burned. So a relative's ghost or anyone else is not what is in your house. You've been lied to if someone's told you this. This is a familiar spirit or a tormenting spirit that's been following you around in your house. And in some way, you've invited this to come into your home or in your dwelling place. And I'll explain more detail on that later. And if this spirit was in there when you moved in, it's still no big deal. We could still get it out. Now, I've laid a little bit of groundwork here so you can understand that it's not a ghost. The very first thing, you cannot skip these next two steps. You cannot. The first thing you need to say out loud is, I forgive every person that has ever hurt me or caused me any harm or pain in my entire life. Now listen here, you cannot do this flippantly. Trust me, you've got to mean it from your heart. Even if these people are dead or nowhere near you, you've got to mean it. You've got to say it. It doesn't matter. What they've done to you, you've got to forgive them. If you want to be free in your house, you've got to stop being petty and do it. If you say, I cannot do it, then we need to stop right here and repeat this after me. Father, help me to forgive this person or persons. Can't do it myself. It hurts too deep. Help me to forgive and to move on with my life in this area. Every time I hear their name, see their face, hear their voice, I will forgive. I will forgive everything they've ever done or said to me. Father, if they hurt me again, right then, I will forgive with your help. Thank you, Father. Now, I loose the spirit and what it's done. And now you need to allow him to do that work inside of you and set it free. And every time it tries to come back to you, you say out loud, no, 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 I gave this to God. I will not receive unforgiveness. Don't allow it to ever rob you again. This is key. Remember, and don't ever, ever forget. Because he can't forgive you if you don't forgive others. Now, if you're not born again, that's the next step. You can't go on if you are not born again. You say, oh, wait a minute. I cannot go there. Look, this is very dangerous. If you are not a saved person, you can't do this. Because a devil cannot cast out a devil. Don't even tempt it. And don't tell me that you do not want to be a part of Christ, because he is the deliverer. Accept it. No, without him there is no freedom. He will set you free from all your bondages. And ask me, how do I know? Because he set me free. Praise his holy name forever. And ever and ever. No, I'm not putting you up against a wall. It's up to you whether you want to live with these spirits and all these bondages and accept him as King of Kings. But you must mean it just like you just forgave these other ones. It's got to come out of your heart. No games with yourself or God. Why? Just what I said from the start. This is no joke here, because the spirits know all the rules. They're not like us. They don't break rules. They're in an army, and they abide by these very strict rules. Forgiveness is one of them, and you being born again is another. Forgiving breaks their hold on you. Forgiveness does. So what do you want to do? So if you really want freedom in your life, pray this. Repeat after me. Father, I'm a sinner. Me. Forgive me, Father. Satan, get out of my life. You are not my Father any longer. I believe that Yesu died on the cross and you rose again on the third day. Thank you, Yesu, for dying for me. Holy Spirit, come inside of me and show me how to change and walk this walk of Christ. Thank you, Father, for forgiving me. Now, Father, look at my heart. If there's any bitterness inside my heart, remove it now. Father, make me clean this minute before you. Thank you, Father. Thank you for forgiving me. Now, if you really meant that, you're born again. You're a new person in Christ. Now, you're going to need to come back and listen to the rest of this because you need a pencil and paper. So I want you just to listen. This is very important. And I want to say welcome to the family because your name has just been written in the book of life in heaven. All of heaven is rejoicing over you. Because I have some things I need to tell you to do. This is an instructional radio show today. I have some things to tell you to do and then some things you need to do. First, I need you to stop watching any scary movies, any scary cartoons, no more in your house. No more rock and roll. Why? Because they attract these kind of spirits into your living place. You say, well, I listen to rock gospel. Oh, stop it. Do you really think they play that in heaven? If you're bebopping and popping to the music, that is not worship. I'm serious. I'm not trying to be funny. So if you want to know what worship is, you can go to YouTube and create a playlist. Worship music free. You don't have to buy it. And listen to it on YouTube. Worship music is not dance music. It is soft, soothing, creating an atmosphere for the Holy Spirit. Just like when King Saul called for David to play the harp and he would chase away the spirits that was on and in him so he could rest. Yeah, that's what it is. Now, I'm going to give you a list of things to look for in your house to burn or throw away. And this is just to get you started. This is not the only things I want you to look for. Because there's many more things that's not on this list. This is just, like I said, to get you started. And I have some scriptures here to help you understand. I sought Yahweh God, and he heard me, and he delivered me of all my fears. That's Psalms 34:4. This poor man, he cried, and Yahweh heard him, and he saved him out of all his troubles. Psalms 34:2, because you got troubles when you've got spirits in your house. The others had fears and pulled them out of the fire, hating even the garments spotted by flesh. This is Jude 1:23. And they buried the clothes that were stained with evil spirits. And when you look this up, word by word, the meaning of this is you have clothing or items of the past that are from people that caused you pain or had wrong spirits. Get rid of them. Burn them. These are love, people that you loved from the past, past marriages, past lovers, whatever. Get rid of these items. burn them. That's what that scripture is telling you, because they have spirits in them or on them. Okay, this is the starting of the list. Anything that's Harry Potter, anything that is China arts, you know, drawings, paintings, anything that's from Japan, artwork, any figurines that are from Asian religions, occult books, a Ouija board, anything to do with witchcraft, anything to do with voodoo, any cartoon figures, any Marvin cartoon books, anything that you have that you would not want the Lord to know that you have in your house if he came to visit you. Pictures of Buddha. Anything that has anything to do with rock and roll, music, books, pictures, anything. Any religious books that has nothing to do with Christianity. Tarot cards. A deck of cards, because witches use these to perform spells. Any games that has to do with witchcraft. Romance books. Anything to do with witchcraft. Anything that you have from a person that you are no longer seeing, you don't need that anymore, because it brings spirits from that relationship that you don't need. Crosses, because they actually have nothing to do with Christianity. Prayer beads, definitely nothing to do with Christianity. And if you have any questions that you're just like, Ruby, that's off the wall, I need an explanation of that, please message me and I will help you understand. Reiki. Prayer books from Catholic Church. Anything related to that. Anything related to yoga, pictures of the dead, pictures from of Catholic churches, pictures of graves, pictures of anybody that you were told to hang on your walls that you pray to, pictures of saints that you've been praying to, burn them. You're not supposed to pray to saints. You're only supposed to pray to the Father. Any idols that you've been burning candles to and praying to, burn the, get rid of the candles and get rid of the idols. Porn books. Troll dolls. Porn DVDs. Porn anything. Books on the dead. Books about the dead. Books about paranormal, books about magic, anything about magic, anything about Buddha, anything that would put you in a trance, any books about that, anything about removing eyeballs, books about tattoos, tattoo kits. If you have many earrings on your body, remove them. Rings that goes on the toes, many bracelets that goes on your ankles. If you have many, many bracelets that goes on your wrist, get rid of them. Anything that's Hindu, nose rings, tongue rings, eyelid rings, Masonic rings, anything that's Masonic, get rid of it. If you wear really bold makeup, get rid of it. Wild hairdo ornaments, get rid of them. Wild hats. That's demonic. Get rid of it. If you wear many belts, any sizes, get rid of them. Pants that are baggy and hang way down, get rid of them. Long, painted, bright-colored fingernails, get rid of them. Long toenails, cut them off. Books on astrology, books about horoscope, books about Wicca, anything about Wicca, anything about horoscope. Plaques of frogs, plaques about owls, pictures of wolves, anything that is American Indian prints, anything about Egyptian art, pictures of oak trees, oak tree worship, Most of this should be burnt. Anything you pray to. Then now, remember, this is just examples. All of this should be removed. Now, at first, I want you to pray this prayer every day. Heavenly Father, I plead the blood of Yesu. Yesu is the true name of Jesus. Over the top of my head to the soles of my feet, I ask for extra protecting angels to watch over me and to lead me and guide me and direct me. And to watch over my speech and to keep me in all your ways throughout this day. I ask you, Father, to watch over my words and to put your words in my mouth and to have me to meet the people that you would want me to meet this day, to open the doors you won't open and to close the doors you won't close. Cause me not to stumble this day, but to give me the glory, your glory. I plead the blood of Yesu over every building that I will be in and out of this day and over every entrance and exit, over every place at my footsteps. Father, to place extra angels over every entrance and exit, that not a hair of my head would be touched this day. I plead the blood of Yesu over every vehicle of every kind that I would be in and out of, that it would get wherever I'm going without an accident, without any flats, without fail. I place angels around about it, before it, behind it, that they would lead me wherever I'm going this day. I plead the blood of Yesu over my children's head, my grandchildren's head, and their spouse. Father, I plead the blood of Yesu over their mind and their spirit, teaching the word to penetrate in their hearts and their minds this day, to open them to the truth, to increase the anointing on our lives, and to give your wisdom from heaven this day. I thank you, Father. I plead the blood of Yesu over our homes and over every entrance and exit of our homes and all of our goings, ins, and out this day, Lord. With extra protecting angels watching over our homes this day. I thank you, Father, in Yesu's holy name. Now you will pray this over every member of your loved ones. And I'm not married, but if I was, I would pray it over my husband. And you pray this every day because you need this to take care of you every single day. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers and against rulers of darkness in this world, against spiritual weaknesses in high places. This is in Ephesians 6 and 12. We need protection every day as we wrestle. So you also need to pray this prayer too. I bind all territorial demonic spirits, every principality, every power spirit, every ruler of darkness, every wicked spirit in high places, all familiar spirits, all spirits above, around and below, mentioned and unmentioned, known and unknown. I bind all evil spirits on assignment against me and my family members. For greater is he who is in me in this world, and no weapon formed against me shall prosper, and every tongue formed against me shall be condemned. I send every curse back to the person that sent it to me, and it go back to them three times greater than what they sent. In Jesus' mighty name, we give you praise and glory for it. Know that there is no name greater than the name of Yesu. That every name that has a name has to bow. And as I've done this, I do it every day. I've seen every spirit run out of homes as I've left every room. And this is what we're fixing to do now. We're going to clean your house. This was the purpose for you listening to this. This is called cleaning your house. And as you go one room at a time. And I usually start in the bathroom. You open up all the drawers. all the doors, and you start praying out loud like this. And you anoint your head and your feet. You plead the blood of Yeshua over yourself, because you usually don't do it in the morning when you start. And now you're ready to fight. And please ask me any questions if you don't understand this. In the name of Yesu, I command all demonic forces, and if you know them, like depression, oppression, suicide, whatever's in your house, say it out loud. But if you don't, you just call them demonic forces. Come out of here. I bind you up. I speak with authority of the name of Yesu Christ. You open up. You're speaking it to the open areas. And then you close them as you speak into them one at a time. You speak into the bathtub area. Don't leave one area unspoken as you are moving. You are kicking your feet toward the door. And when you're finished, you close the door and seal it by pleading the blood of Yesu over it, with anointing it at the top with oil from your finger. It just takes one little touch. You can use whatever oil you've got. It doesn't really matter. The oil signifies the Holy Spirit. You anoint everything you touch as you close it back. If that room has a window, you anoint the window. Please don't miss anything. This is called sealing off the room. It shows the demons that you mean business. And demons is a spirit, so they're the same thing. You will do this in each room, down the hallways, until you get to the front door. You open the front door and you kick the spirits out, naming them one by one. That's if you know the name of them. If you don't, that's fine too. You will bind them and gag them and cast them to the outer darkness. You have this authority in the name of Jesus Christ. He gave it to you. You go outside. You kick them off the sidewalk. If you have one, off the porch. You don't want them on your property. If you have a car, you want to anoint everything in that car. You don't want them in your car. You're wanting rid of these suckers. And then you anoint yourself again. You ask the Lord to give you peace that passes all understanding. You don't want them to ever get another toehold in your dwelling place again. And you will know when they're back in there. Because even a person that visits your dwelling place can bring them back in. Because now you have peace. You'll feel it. Because they're gone. You just, once you've got them all, it'll feel like a brand new place. And you know, you should do this even when you go into a motel room, because there's hitchhiking spirits. They'll hitchhike and you'll bring them home from the motel rooms. When you visit a relative, you can do it in the room that you sleep in, because they'll get in your suitcase. I'm kidding you not. I've been around the mulberry bush a time or two myself. This is important. You're in a warfare now. You can do it. Greater is he that's in you than he that's in this world. You can do it. Praise his holy name. You can do it. I give you the keys of the kingdom. What you bind on heaven is bound. What you bind on earth is bound in heaven, and what's loosed on earth is loosed in heaven. You're binding and loosing. You can lose peace that passes all understanding. And it's up to you to live free are in bondage. He gave us freedom. He is the deliverer. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name forever and ever and ever. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord. This is how you clean your house. It's not that hard. There's nothing to be afraid of as long as you're born again. You must be born again. That's the key. And you must walk in forgiveness all the time. All the time. And how you keep them out is you don't let these things back in. You guard your heart and you keep your dwelling place clean. You don't have beer parties in your house. That lets the spirits in. I mean, let's get real. You're born again. Why would you walk in darkness? Yeah, I've known a born-again people having beer parties. I wouldn't have said that. So, you guard your living place so that you can sleep in peace and these spirits won't return. You wash your mind in his word because it's important to read his word. And you worship. You play godly music. That's why you don't want to have rock and roll. And you be careful what you watch on TV because it lets spirits in. Because most of what's on TV is not godly. You be careful what you read and who you let in your dwelling place. If someone comes to visit that's not a Christian and you know they had spirits on them, then you get out your anointing oil and you get those spirits out as soon as they leave. This is your right as a born-again believer. Stand up for your rights. Be bold. There's no reason to walk in fear anymore. Greater is he that's in you than he that's in this world. Put the sword of the Spirit in your mouth and use it. You know, I had trouble logging in today to have this radio show because Satan didn't want me to have it. Because there's someone out there that really, really desperately needed to hear what I'm having, what I'm talking about tonight. Go back and listen to it. Listen to it over and over and write down everything I said. Write down all the prayers. If you need help, please message me. My name is Ruby. I'm here to help you. I'm a minister. I'm in deliverance ministry. And I'm just a vessel that pours out. God loves you. And he sent me tonight as his hand extended to reach out to help you in your time and need. And he says, I'm here. I heard your cry.